Hey guys, welcome back. In today's video, we're going to touch on the topic that's on everybody's mind, ChatGPT, and how that can be used alongside your coding. We will be using the AI to generate some Laravel code by providing it certain inputs. We will provide the inputs using pseudocode and see if it can translate that into proper Laravel code. Now, how ChatGPT AI works is that it provides output based on the amount or quality of input you provide. So the more details you can provide within your input, the more accurate your output will be. But we will start with a simple command like creating a Laravel function for storing a book model. And let's see what happens. All right, so it seems like it's understanding that needs to create a Laravel function for storing a book model. It tells us to create the migration files and the model. So I'm just going to stop the video here and I'll come back when it's finished. Okay, so now for a look at the code that was generated, we can see firstly it tells us that we need to create a book model. All right, then it provides us with the whole class where we create the migration. And as you can see, it's pretty smart because I didn't tell it that a book needs to have a title, an author, or a description. It automatically placed that inside the migration for us. Now, it also tells the next steps that we need to migrate, which is very good. Then it gives us the command to create a book controller, which is also good. Now, this is the store function within the book controller. We've got the store function. We've got the request. Then you've got some validation, again, on the three fields that it provides. It then creates a new book instance, assigns the information from the request, and then it creates and automatically redirects to a route with a success message. Then at the bottom, you can see here, it also has provided us with the relevant routes in the routes file. Okay, so let's look at the store method in our book controller. Now, while there's nothing wrong with this code, it validates the information from the request, it assigns it to the properties of the book instance, it saves it, it then redirects to a URL or a route with a success message. We can utilize more of Laravel's advanced features in order to make this store method a lot shorter. So let's rewrite this method by using form requests and resource classes. So let's say rewrite the store method and use form request and resource classes. And then we could also say provide function return types. All right, so let's see what it generates for us now. Okay, so now it says it's going to generate a new request, store book request. Naming convention is absolutely perfect. Let's see what it generates for us. Yep, now it generates the resource class. Then it provides all the return fields. And then it realizes that it needs to update the store method in the book controller to accommodate for these new changes. So it's rewriting the store, the book controller basically. Okay, brilliant. As you can see now, it automatically used a lot of Laravel's advanced features in order to make this book controller or this store method in the book controller a lot shorter. Now we will see if we can get ChatGPT to rewrite the store method and make it a one-liner. Okay, so let's rewrite the store method to use minimal. See if it can translate that into a one-liner. Now, as you can see, it reduced the amount of code, but it is still not exactly what we want. It's not a one-liner. So let's rewrite it again and ask for it specifically to be a one-liner to see what it can do for us. Rewrite the store method to be a one-liner. Let's see what happens. Okay, so now as you can see, it created exactly what we wanted, but there's a lot of input that we needed to provide in order for it to create that one line of code. Now, as you can see, that one line of code is not easy to read. So let's try and ask it to make it more readable for us. So rewrite the store method and make it easier to read. Okay, now it's creating the store method for us. Let's see what it can come up with. So now, as you can see, it extracted it again from being a one-liner into multiple lines, but it's easier to read, which is not much different from what we've previously provided or received back. So in order for it to get it a one-liner and easier to read, we've got to ask for it to do specific things. So let's go back and say, rewrite the one-liner store method and use indentation. Let's see what it can do for us. And there we go. Now it used the one liner and it used line breaks and indentation to make it easier to read. So as you can see, overall, we had to provide a lot of detailed information in order for it to provide or generate the exact code that we want. So it's not like we can just tell ChatGPT a one line of pseudocode and it's going to automatically provide everything we need in the top or the high standard advanced Laravel code that we ended up with in this scenario. There's a lot of confusion currently in the world where people are worried that ChatGPT is going to replace you as a developer. I'd say don't worry about that at this stage and rather think of ChatGPT as a tool that can help you in your daily coding rather than something that's going to replace you as a developer. Thank you so much for watching, guys, and see you in the next one.